We saw this concept already. The concept of indirect material. An indirect material means originating material. Recall that to qualify for NAFTA, one of the concepts you have to meet is the concept of originating. And we learned that originating is a term of art. And it can be something which is also known as indirect material. And indirect material is really stuff that is helping you to make the product in a final stage of what it is that you will be importing into the United States. It is the collateral factors of production, if you will. And we have under the North American Free Trade Agreement, we have a laundry list of stuff that are qualifying as indirect materials. And customs examiners, because it's a laundry list, it is provided in Harmonized Tariff Schedule General Note 12, then customs will likely test you on that laundry list itself. So let's take a look of what that laundry list consists of. First of all, you have indirect equals originating. The second thing is the term indirect material means the production and testing inspection of the good, but not physically incorporated. Here is the buzzword, not physically incorporated. So if it is something which becomes a product, so if you use a chemical substance to create some kind of reaction to make a new chemical compound, that is incorporation. However, if you have things which you use in production, testing, and inspection, so if you use, for example, the chemical, using that, going back to that chemical reaction example, if you use the chemical kit to test the properties after you made that chemical reaction, then that is not physically incorporated, that is indirect, and that qualifies as testing and inspection. Maintenance production in the maintenance product which is made in using the maintenance of buildings or operation of the equipment. And here comes the laundry list that I was mentioning. Fuel and energy, tools, dyes and molds, spare parts, materials, lubricants, greases, compounds, gloves, glasses, footwear, clothing. So those are the stuff that, for example, the plant employees will wear to create something, right? Those are the materials that are used to facilitate the production of the product. Equipment, devices, and supplies used for testing. So recall that chemical testing kit. Or, and here is a kind of covered all clothes. Any other goods that are not incorporated in the good, but whose use in the production of a good can reasonably be demonstrated to be part of the production. So as long as it doesn't become part of the good, but it becomes part of the production, then you're good to go. Or things which you use in production, testing, and inspection. So if you use, for example, the chemical, using that, going back to that chemical reaction example, if you use the chemical kit to test the properties after you made that chemical reaction, then that is not physically incorporated, that is indirect. And that qualifies as testing and inspection. Maintenance production in the maintenance product which is made in using the maintenance of buildings or operation of the equipment. And here comes the laundry list that I was mentioning. Fuel and energy, tools, dyes and molds, spare parts, materials, lubricants, greases, compounds, gloves, glasses, footwear, clothing. So those are the stuff that, for example, the plant employees will wear to create something, right? Those are the materials that are used to facilitate the production of the product. Equipment, devices, and supplies used for testing. So recall that chemical testing kit. Or, and here is the kind of covered all clothes. Any other goods that are not incorporated in the good, but whose use in the production of a good can reasonably be demonstrated to be part of the production. So as soon as it doesn't become part of the good, but it becomes part of the production, then you're good to go. All right, so let's see how examiners test on this. So question tests you on exceptions. So notice the pattern. You have a laundry list of items, and you're looking for one that's not. So a good test in using and testing inspection of the good, but not physically incorporated. Remember that not physical incorporation clause is it. So A is good. A good used in the maintenance of buildings, and recall this indirect material is a term of art. That's why it has this quotation marks. So maintenance of buildings and operation of the equipment. We saw that over here. So this one is a qualifier. Maintenance of buildings or operation of the equipment. A good used in the production of a good, whether or not physically incorporated. And here is the killer, right? Whether or not. It cannot be whether or not. It must be not physically incorporated. Whether or not is something which makes this an exception to the rule. It's something that kicks it out of the laundry list. So C is the correct answer because we're looking for exception. Let's read other stuff. An indirect material shall be considered to be originating material without regard where it is produced. So remember that concept originating and indirect. That means that wherever it comes from, it doesn't have to come from Canada. It doesn't have to come from any other NAFTA country. This case being United States and Mexico. It can be any country, and it qualifies as originating. In other words, it can be China, and you can still qualify the product as originating. So this D is a punchline for general concept, and this is valuable stuff because whenever you're determining the original value content, which you have to for the sum for some of the product, you can include that indirect material value, and the indirect material can affect the formula in a favorable way for the importer. So this is the reason why you wanna it may be in your interest to include as much as possible of the indirect material as you can. Now a good is not incorporated into the good. That's good, right? We don't want it something to be incorporated. But whose use in the production of the good can reasonably be demonstrated to be part of the production? Yes, this is the restatement of that last catch-all clause, remember? We're talking about this one, where it pretty much refers anything that facilitates production but is not part of it.